Coach Greg, and I just found out that John Meadows, very famous bodybuilder and coach and online personality, has just suffered a heart attack. He's alive, he's in hospital recovering, and I don't know the extent of the damage, but I do know that he has a heart attack. His wife went on Facebook and made this post. It says, this is Mary. John has suffered a heart attack today. His blood vessels appear to be fine, potentially a clotting disorder with his blood. He's in the hospital now. Please keep him in your prayers. Thank you. So John Meadows is close to 50 years old. I honestly don't know exactly how old he is. He's a bit older than me. He's a competitive bodybuilder, and we know he's not natural. However, he's not abusive in his doses. So a lot of people, I am sure, are going to just 100% assume what's because of what he's taking. You can't assume these things. You can't. So I just want to explain something. When you take PEDs, you increase your risk of a heart attack. You do. If you take anabolics, you're increasing your risk. If you're prescribed by a doctor and it's medically necessary and it's in low doses, this is not the case, okay? But if you're abusing them, if you're using them in higher doses beyond what is normally prescribed by a doctor, your chances of dying go up, okay? Your chance of getting a heart attack go up. Now, does that mean you're going to? No, it's not. And for all we know, if John hadn't have done all his cardio, all his training, all these years, he might have got a heart attack 10 years ago. It might have extended his life so that he was able to get this far into it before he got the heart attack. Now, not everybody knows this, but cardiovascular training, exercise, being fit, getting your heart rate up, it literally increases your chance of actually surviving a heart attack if you do get one. Okay, what happens? Well, when you get a heart attack, there's a blockage in an artery and it prevents the blood from going to the heart. If this happens in your head, you get a stroke. If he blocks a certain part of the brain, blood flow, okay? Can be in many different forms and it can happen in different ways. If you get a heart attack and you have exercised, your body has the ability to get blood to flow to the heart in other means. There's smaller blood vessels that the blood can flow around and get to the heart, okay? By exercising, cardio all the time, you know, at least 150 minutes a week, it's gonna allow these other connections to work better, to be more of them, so you have more blood flow, so you literally survive this heart attack that much more. So take me for example. If I ride my bike all the time and get a heart attack, I am more likely to survive this than if I don't ride my bike and get a heart attack. Say, so another reason to exercise. So why does taking PEDs increase your chance of getting a heart attack? Well, what testosterone does, for example, in almost anybody, and it's dose related, the higher you take it, the more this does it. And it's also genetic. So some people, they can take it and not really get a bad effect. Others, even a small amount, and they get a bad effect, okay? HDL, the good cholesterol, it lowers it dramatically. You need this, the good cholesterol. The bad cholesterol, LDL, it raises it. That ratio gets even more skewed. The higher the dose, the worse. I personally have abused these things. My HDL-LDL ratio was at 8-1 at one point, and 6-1 is kind of considered the cutoff of health. After that, it's not so good. My ratio right now is 2.5-1. 3-1 or better is amazing. So I personally am very good. But doesn't mean that what I did in my past doesn't affect my future, okay? It can't just say, oh, it's gonna have no effect. It might have an effect. We don't know. We just don't know. So it's one of the dangers of using anabolics is in fact an increased chance of getting cardiovascular disease, including a heart attack. So I'm not saying, yeah, oh, it's because he used this. And I'm not saying, no, it's not because I don't know. I am not a freaking doctor. And a doctor wouldn't know. You don't know. If you knew, if there was an exact test that you could do, oh, let's just get this exact blood work. Boom, you know. It would be amazing, but we don't. It's like Russian roulette. And so I'm saying this because let it be somewhat of a warning. Like, it is a risk. If it's HRT dose, doctor prescribed doses, like right now, my dose is 140 milligrams a week and I'm in normal reference range. This is not an increased risk. It's not, okay? Your doctor's saying you should take this. You listen to your doctor. That's what they're for. You don't not take medicine that your doctor gives you. But if you say, oh, instead of 140 milligrams, I'm going to do 1,040 because I want to be huge. I want to grow more. I don't want to be cautioned. I don't want to hold back. I want the best. It's a risk you're willing to take, then you're taking it. But you shouldn't. Okay? You shouldn't. So, John, we wish him the best. We wish him a speedy recovery. We hope he pulls through this. You know, he's been a fit guy. He trains hard. He exercises hard. And so his chances of surviving are that much better. I just explained why. So he's much more likely to overcome this, much more likely to come back and be better than ever, okay? But if you're watching this and you're on that anabolic stuff, maybe you should reconsider. Maybe you should lower your dose to HRT levels. Maybe you should say to yourself, is it worth it? And if you're not doing cardio, because, well, I'm not going to get any gains because it's cardio. I don't want to hold myself back. Is it worth not doing cardio just so you can have 5 more pounds of muscle? Are those 5 extra pounds of muscle worth 5 years of your life? Is it really? Really think about it. Is chasing that elusive IFBB Pro card worth it? Is your life going to be that much better with 5 more pounds of muscle? If it is, well, then do what you got to do. Same thing as drinking. Is getting drunk every Friday night worth it for you? If it is, then we'll do what you got to do. But there's things we choose to do that are not so good for us. Eating junk food, eating crap all the time, getting drunk, using drugs, all these things are bad things that we do. If you're going to do it, you do it. But you should at least think about it. Think of the consequences. Are they worth doing? Are they not worth doing? If you just don't care and don't think about it, then you're living in denial. Ignorance is bliss, they say. It's a very famous saying. You don't want to know. Don't test me. I don't want to know if I have cancer. I don't want to know if I have an STD. I don't want to get my blood work because what if it comes back and I find out that my HDL is low and my LDL is high? Then I'll have to lower my dose. I don't want to know. I'm not getting blood work. Do you know how many people actually get blood work? Hardly any. I coach a lot of people. Hardly anyone gets it. I try to convince everybody you should get your blood. It's this going on. It's hard to get a doctor. It's every freaking excuse. At least do your due diligence. At least get your blood work done. At least check with your doctor and have yourself monitored to make sure you're healthy. Obviously, John Meadows has done all this stuff. Just because you do it doesn't mean you're immune. Doesn't mean you'll never get something, okay? Just because you're healthy, it doesn't mean you can't get something bad happen to you. Okay, but at least do the best to be proactive to prevent this from happening in the first place. And trust me, if you're not doing cardio, you're missing out on potential life-saving activity. If you're eating crap, you're missing out on life-saving activity. If you're obese, I don't care if you want to self-accept yourself and decide that, oh, I should just weigh this way and forgive myself because it's this time of flipping uncertainty and I'm going to eat whatever I want and body acceptance. Accept the fact you're increasing your chances of dying. If you can do that, then so be it, okay? Anyway, I'm going to close this with wishing John Meadows a speedy recovery. GregDucette.com for coaching. Greg Doucette, IFBU Pro. Watch one of these other videos. You know, you got a lot of educational stuff against the use of PEDs. Watch one of these because maybe it'll make you think twice before you take something. And GregDucette.com for coaching. Greg Doucette, IFBU Pro. Like the video, subscribe, click bell buttons. Let's wish John the best. Hopefully he recovers. And until next time, I'm out.